Hey guys, so today we are gonna make a classic hummus recipe. Hummus is a Middle Eastern dish, particularly from Lebanese cuisine, and it is used as a dip, a spread, or even a savory to be included in many other dishes. Hummus is easily available in the market right now, and we get different variants of it, but I like to make it at home because the commercial products have a lot of preservatives and they are stored for longer shelf life and all that. And besides, making a hummus at home is pretty easy, quick, and it's super fresh, and I just love it making at home and having it with my dishes. It's gluten-free, it's vegan, and it's a great option if you want to, you know, start with eating healthy or on a weight loss journey and want to include a low-calorie snack. So it definitely suits. So today we are going to make a classic hummus recipe, for which I have boiled about 80 grams of chickpeas and removed the skins out of them. So you can see that I have removed all the skins. These skins tend to make the hummus a little coarse, and we need a very smoother one. So when you remove these, you get all goodness here, and the hummus turns out to be super soft and creamy. About these skins, you don't have to dump it in the garbage. You can always use it in your garden for compost making, etc. So these are good too. But we are going to use only the chickpeas here. The ingredients are super simple. I'll just keep adding in and letting you know. So to begin with, in 80 grams of chickpeas, I'm going to add 2 garlic pods. You can take 2 large ones, too much is not required, we just need a subtle flavor of it. And on that, usually on hummus we use tahini, but I'm not making tahini on a general basis at home. I usually take sesame seeds. So here is the white sesame seeds, which I blend right into it, and it turns out to be that tahini taste. I'm just going to add 1 spoonful of sesame seeds here. Thereafter, I have olive oil right here. I'm going to add just a little bit here, and the rest we are going to add when we blend it in the mixer. There's lemon juice, which is like 1 tablespoon. I'm going to add only 1/2 tablespoon here. And then there is salt. You can add salt as per taste. I like to keep it a little subtle, so I'm just adding about 1/2 tablespoon here. So now all our ingredients are in, and it's ready for blending. For blending, you don't really need any fancy blender or a food processor. You can do it in your home mixer grinder, because the chickpeas are boiled and it's going to be super smooth in process to do that. So we are just going to take this to the mixer blender and blend it. So guys, we're done with the blending, and this is how the texture has turned out to be. It's super, super creamy, soft, and a little puffed up, but that is how we want our hummus to turn out to be. Let's get plating.